Don't knock it, honey. Alex, I'll be home late.
Do you need a ride home, Jennifer?
Oh, no, I'm gonna walk Michael to the diner.
In the rain, to the other side of town.
I don't mind.
It's a little hard to watch.
Jennifer, when I'm with you, it's like there's this, I just feel something deeper than the night. I feel this something, 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 something.
Oh, Michael, you always know just what to say.
Look at us.
It's so pathetic. Why is it every time I see someone young and happy like that, I just want to smack them?
I don't know, but that's an interesting quality in a teacher.
What is it on anyway?
I don't know, maybe a man?
Another man? Jesus, Lexa. Besides, I thought we all agreed men are not the answer.
Okay, well, somewhat.
New.
Yes.
And mysterious.
Artistic.
Simple and honest. You know, like a caveman. And
devastatingly handsome.
Prince on horseback.
In Eastwick, we don't even have our own post office.
Well, there's no harm in dreaming, is there?
If I could ask, if I could choose, what sort of man might fill the shoes?
I'd like to find inside my door. What man might fill those Tom McCanns?
What would I ask?
Yes. What indeed?
What would I dare?
What would I dare? I'd ask the moon.
I'd ask
if I thought the moon would care.
Right. We're gonna do this. We're gonna do this right, girls.
All manner of men in one man.
fellas to Condell's Clyde. Do you want a summer person moving in there? The wrong sort? It wasn't that many generations ago that house was in my family. I will have it. It's my birthright. The birthright of all of Eastwick, thank you very much. Including your own daughter. Where is Jennifer anyway? You didn't let her go with that Michael Spofford boy yet, did you?
So now you don't trust me.
Well, you're never here, are you, Clyde? You're always tucked away in that newspaper office. With that stuttering dimwit Suki, what's her name?
Bougemont. Suki Bougemont.
I suppose she'll be at the concert tonight?
Things happen.
Oh, really? Do you think I don't see the way you look at Suki Bougemont? The way you drool and gape? All you want to is true, but you can't see it through because you don't.
Beneath you, I swear to God!
You're not fooling anyone, Clyde! Gave your residence.
Felicia, it's Brenda. Big news. I just got off the phone with Marsh Dolly over at Curly Real Estate.
Don't tell me she's opened up long enough to actually sell a house.
Not just any house, Felicia.
No.
It hurts to be the one to have to tell you this.
The Lennox house, but how?
The new owner paid cash, moved in this very morning from New York.
Heaven help us!
Word is, he's already planning all sorts of improvements to the property. Filling in the wetlands out back?
No!
Tearing down the elm trees.
My elm trees? No, I will not stand for this!
Nor should you, dear. Take your case to the zoning commission. Take it straight to the people of Eastwick.
The people of Eastwick?
Marshmallow squares. What more could a man ask aside that is from a perfectly mixed martini? And you three ladies like martinis. There's nothing I enjoy so much as somewhere tucked away. It's the same from day to day.
Little life, draw the small town home.
backyard dodgers. Oh my god, that's probably like an enlightenment in this godforsaken place. Christ, well, freaking mighty, what have I got myself into? Well, you take a gun right now and shoot me right between them. I'm so sorry, Mr. Precision isn't prissy. Precision is where passion begins, and without passion, well, the coup de rein, oui.
Oui.
I'm afraid that it's this hand that's a flying ointment.
How so?
Your bowing.
What about it?
It sucks. Your spiccato sounds like legato, your legato sounds like the shed. You're not playing notes, you're playing lines, for Christ's sake. Cries from the heart, swing from the soul! It's like making love, Jamie. You've got to get in. You've got to let go.
I was.
It's like that music you're trying to play.
Oh, sentimental indulgence slot, more like.
You're only saying that because you can't do it justice. Yet.
Just not in the mood for that piece.
You're always in the mood for that piece. You know the notes. They'll go beyond.
When I was 12,
hand-picked friend out on the street over there.
Who, Clyde? Oh, that sweet, sweet man. Let's just say, after the divorce, Clyde is the one person who didn't judge me for it, and I'll always be grateful to him for that.
So I gather. What about the books? Starting your own library?
Oh, just reading up. On your house, actually.
All the books on my humble little boat. Why not? Even this one?
My journal! Oh, that's my journal! Please, it's personal, really. It's scribblings. It's poetry.
Ah, so Miss Swiss is a budding poetess. Just promise me a signed first edition.
Oh, no, I'm not a real writer or anything. Well, I'm a real writer for the paper, but these are, well, they're...
Do you write what you talk, or do you use complete sentences?
No, what I'm writing is fine, but, well, talking, the cat's always getting my tongue.
Cat?
It's always been that way, I'm afraid, even back in school. Way, way back in school.
Why don't you tell me all about it, Suki, darling?
Really?
Really?
Well, just picture it.
Here you are!
But words, 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 words,
point is, one look and I knew the artist was in need of rescue.
Rescue? Rescue from what?
Herself. Yourself.
Well, time out, buddy.
You have to stop treating yourself like crap, Alex.
How do they all find me?
You want proof? I'm here 10 seconds, and what's the first thing I hear come out of your mouth? Look at me, I'm fat.
I prefer Rubenesque, thank you very much.
AKA fat. What is wrong with women that can never call something what it is? So you were dealing with fat. What's wrong with fat? There was nothing wrong with fat, though clearly you think there's something wrong with fat, and that makes you feel small. That is a sad irony, isn't it? Fat makes Alexander feel small. Why? Why should something as magnificent as you be wasting your time on something as insignificant as this? My God! Look at you. What a time. Ripe for display. Smelling of earth. Pillaged homes. It's in clay.
Who do you think you are?
Just your average horny devil. Feel free to touch.
Who do you think you are to talk to me like that? You don't know me.
Alexander Spock. I know you. The chubby teenager gave handy to the back of the school bus. 62. Now the second housewife any man can have for the price of a sideways glance. Fully clothed, mind you, and always for the lights off.
Go to hell.
I have a gift to that diamond. Forced. I have a knack for responding to my genius. Yes. I have an eye for seeing. Yes, the BS. And what some consider boring, I consider worth exploring.
I have an eye for spotting men with designs. I have a sense for all the obvious signs. And pal, I know when someone's feeding me lines. Don't feel too bad. You had your touch. You had your touch, but not with me. I have an eye.
That's why.
No, really.
formidable creature. Ladies, put you together. Holy shit. Put you together. You'll never know fear again. Let me show you.
Who are you?
You already know the answer.
Make him mine.
Admire, lover, father.
Make him mine.
Teacher, master, slave.
Make him handsome as the devil, yet perfectly divine.
Anything your heart desires, the ultimate companion, the ideal design. All matter of man in one man.
Make him
ours.
What?
There you go.
All three of us?
No, all four of us.
Who wants another martini?
Second door on the left by the jacuzzi.
Oh, what the hell?
Going off to class next week, I mean.
Let's worry about tomorrow, and try and concentrate on tonight.
Jennifer, when I'm with you.
Yeah?
It's like.
Yeah?
There's this.
Yeah?
I just feel.
Thank you.
Yeah.
women such great artists. That ability to create, to nurture.
Not all women know how to nurture, Daryl.
To wit, your friend Felicia Gabriel.
That woman is no one's friend. Just ask her husband.
Clyde? Oh my god, Clyde! I forgot all about him!
I wish I may. 15-minute interval, with refreshments served in the foyer. Fidel is making his famous Igrecatiatore. I predict magic.
Thank you. stationery? Hey, Mr. Gabriel. I bet I know who that's from. My angel.
Yeah. Jennifer really seems to love it out there in Stanford.
Can you blame her? It's an exciting place.
I know. I mean, I just wish she was a little more homesick. I'm sorry, you're probably not the person I should be talking to about this.
No, no, I'm flattered. You know, no one's ever asked me advice about a woman before.
Why?
And in walks the reason why.
There you are, Clyde. Is this what you call an important errand?
I was just on my way.
Where, Clyde? Where were you just on your way to?
Home, Felicia? I was just on my way home.
And is that supposed to make me feel better? You know, there are some days where I can't imagine my life getting any worse.
My God.
And yet, somehow it always does.
Would you get a load of this place?
Come on, Clyde, we're leaving.
Ah, if it isn't the lovely... No, no, don't tell me. Felicity. Fiona. Veruca.
Felicia!
I think I prefer Veruca.
Some days it doesn't pay to get out of bed.
You're preaching to the choir, sweetheart. Oh, don't look so sour. Have a cherry.
Keep your fruit to yourself, Mr. Van Horn.
What have I done to warrant such animosity?
To me, nothing. To this town, plenty.
Oh, Christ, are you still pretending this is about those goddamn egrets?
Those birds are endangered species, Mr. Van Horn, and thanks to you, they have no place to live.
Who fucking knew?
Actually, Mrs. Gabriel, there are dead elm trees all across the bay. They could nest anywhere.
Michael Spofford, given your upbringing, I don't expect you to fully understand this. But jumping from bed to bed does not a home make. Now why don't you run along and attend the dirty cutlery and leave the good of this town to those who know it better?
You don't get much, do you?
I beg your pardon?
Listen, honey. This town, hell, life itself. It's like a cherry. Everywhere you care to look is bright, sweet, juicy, red flesh. Yours for the enjoying. But some people like you, all they see, all they know is a pit. Pity.
If I thought for one moment...
My God, a cherry pit.
What are the odds, right?
Come on, Clyde, we're leaving.
Is it just me? Or are the women in this town a little tense? I mean, goddammit, is there not one man here who knows how to satisfy a woman, huh? Spofford, huh? I know your mom.
I know you do.
You have her smile. At least you would if you were actually smiling. Well, thanks.
Girlfriend problem, she won't know it is.
Not really. No.
Hey, maybe you could...
What?
Nothing, never mind.
So, if you want my help, you have to ask for it. You have to lift up that nice intention of yours, swell your girlish pride, and say, Mr. Van Horn, help me!
Mr. Van Horn, help me!
Calm me down. Class is in session. You might want to take notes there.
It's Michael.
Yes. See, this girl in your heart stops cold.
just watch her fall.
She likes to dance with the devil.
And heaven be praised, he's inside us all.
The devil inside you.
Getting that kid?
brandy and the hot tub.
So, what did you come over for then? I feel like such a whore.
Some of us could have been a little more discreet.
Oh, this again?
There's been a little talk in town.
A little talk?
They're just being babies, Daryl. I haven't heard a thing.
They're not going to say it to our faces, are they?
They are talking.
Call it intuition.
Call it paranoia.
Guys, come on!
Alex, you're doing it again. Just when you're starting to get some size to your work, you're letting little things pull you back down to earth. What about your education?
Exactly. Teach us something new tonight, Daryl. Chapter 7, pops the noodles. Doesn't he ever knock?
Do's me in here, Fidel. Society are suing me for zoning violations. God damn it, Joni! Town council yahoos! I had to grease up to make this place livable!
Oh, poor baby, let's get
an affront to nature! I painted the backyard green, for Christ's sake! What the hell do they want from me?
See, too many people know Daryl.
Felicia Gabriel, chairperson. That miserable little harpy!
That woman's got the whole town on a tight leash. There's no telling what she can do. She puts her natural mind to it.
You keep riding her, we've got a real problem here, you know? Wetlands business?
Yeah. Well, someone ought to fill in her wetlands.
This just proves my point.
No. This just proves my point. Fidel?
That battle axe is doing everything she can to ruin our lives.
She's hated us from get-go.
All of us.
Michael, too, that awful, awful woman. Someday she's gonna get hers.
And I'd love to be the one to give it to her.
Consider this your midterm exam.
Let's do it. Have a pin, chocolate pudding, and a bottle for a thread. Jury pits.
It's
a
paper.
And a spy box instead.
Journal cooking.
Using tabs. 2 cans
of Diet Coke.
Broken buttons.
Crayon.
I am new. That's a joke.
Oh.
Where the hell were you? I needed you!
I'm gonna need a scotch. Wanna join me?
By all means, every trick that's your answer to everything, isn't it? There isn't a problem on God's green earth that can't be solved by a shoe's knit. And 8 drinks on life's looking sweet. You get lost in the haze. And an appetite troll. Blind to the blackness of bread and swallow's town hall.
I don't know what you're talking about, Felicia.
You never do. You never... A silver dollar!
Hey, look at that! She's finally paying off!
Evil plight. Everywhere it can be, I can see evil plight. Would you just look around?
story goes, after he did the little woman in, he hanged himself in the closet. Hang himself? Hung himself? Screw it. Who cares? Point is, I haven't heard from you gals in a few days. Everything all right? Call me.
See?
I understand. There must be, you know, a lot of
loose ends. Yeah. Boxes and boxes of papers, old photographs, and letters.
Letters?
It's okay, Suki. I knew about you and Daddy. You two saw each other for so long, nothing you could say would really shock me.
I wish that was true.
Just been sitting here, talking to myself like some sort of crazy person, asking Mommy and Daddy what I should do next. Do I stay here? Do I go back to college?
Maybe you have some advice.
Advise me? Well, Jennifer, college is so... And of course, Isaac will always be... You know what, I'm probably the last person you should be asking for advice right now, Angel. I gotta go.
Angel? That's what my daddy used to call me.
Jennifer, Angel, I wish there was something I could do, or undo, or say, but right now, what's there even to talk about?
Truly swell people, truly, but you must know that at least one of them is in a much better place. Poor little Diva likes a Greek drama. One thunderbolt, go to heaven's crown. You've got a rough time staring you dead in the eye, and the whole of the town looking on. March, you might be one switch short of a breakdown. The cannon's back. Before the last straw, so sad you could plot, scrub your knickers and nuts. Well, Angel, just leave your knickers to mom. Cause Jennifer, Daryl Van Horn could be a font of compassion.
Mother once warned me of what, I'm not sure.
No, honestly, Daryl Van Horn has got a warm side, it's true.
They figured in there, my mind is a blur.
I said, new wager, after a fashion, the competent and fatherly too. Children, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Well, what do you know? Daryl Van Horn has that in common with you.
is, she's a whore.
Mom!
Boy, did she ever have me fooled.
saying your prayers. You bitches! You think you've won? Cross the plot.